Alanzine is a sedative with analgesic and muscle relaxant properties that are used in veterinary medicine. It is used to calm and facilitate the handling of a variety of animal species, including cattle, sheep, and horses, as well as to perform diagnostic and surgical procedures, relieve pain, and act as a local anesthetic. Philadelphia, xylazine began to gain popularity in the mid-2010s. People who used and sold drugs alleged that xylazine had become a highly sought-after substance and that it has become a much more common component of the local drug supply. Reports from Philadelphia, as well as hints that xylazine was appearing in other parts of the country, prompted the researchers and colleagues to try to track the drug's spread across the continental United States. Xylazine was found in 0.36% of overdose deaths in 2015, according to research. It increased to 6.7% by 2020. It was found in 1 out of every 5 overdose deaths in some. early life stressors such as being abused or witnessing trauma. Two, abuse either physical or sexual in the past. Three, genetic vulnerability such as other family members who struggle with addiction. Four, prenatal alcohol or drug exposure while in the womb. 5. Lack of parental supervision or monitoring during adolescence, peer pressure from friends or social circles, or association with drug using peers. 5. Mental health disorders such as depression and anxiety. A person's susceptibility to addiction can be influenced by a combination of genetic and environmental factors. Genetics, according to National Institute on Drug Abuse, accounts for roughly half of a person's likelihood of developing an addiction. As a result, environmental risk factors such as stress, trauma, abuse, a lack of education, low-income neighborhoods, and It's no longer a choice for them to use drugs. It is beyond their control. When a person uses drugs, the brain produces dopamine, a pleasure chemical. This causes a euphoric bodily response and mental state in the user, making him or her feel good or high. When the brain is exposed to this on a regular basis, it becomes reliant on the feel-good behavior. As a result, it hardwires those euphoric drug-using experiences into its circuitry, and drug use becomes its top priority. These are physical changes that will occur. The brain's reward system, a primitive system that exists to ensure we seek what we need, becomes hardwired to prioritize drug use over all other activities. Such as eating, sleeping, family, and academics. Even when the drugs no longer provide pleasure to the user, which happens over time as the user becomes tolerant to them, the brain continues to push this need. Addiction recovery necessitates changes in routines and thought processes. It entails substituting healthy behaviors such as exercise and cooking. The number of people living on Kensington streets varies according to official estimates. Officials from the city's housing department estimated 300 people, while law enforcement estimated over 600.